Alright, hey everyone. Welcome back to Gaming with Dog. I hope you all had a fun time this week. sorry about missing out on Wednesday. Our net provider was just wonky as heck. Sorry about that. So, gah! Oh. Had my earphones a little too high there. Ow. Anyway. So. We now have large chunks of the, we now have, our main cast of characters back and ready for action. So let's see here. We have some suggestions for interesting side quests to do, so let's check this out. Zoom along. Now you can see around here, you can just barely see the city of Narshe. But we're going to be looking just a little farther along. There should be a place around here in the mountains or so. Here it is. This little cross. Our little cruciform grove of trees here. And this little hidden cabin. Master Duncan! Oh!
Why the surprised face? Did you think I died or something?
Oh, Master Duncan, I'm so glad you're safe!
Oh dear. Sabin, you aren't crying, are you? Did you think a little thing like the end of the world was gonna do me in? The Earth tried to swallow me up once or twice, but I just pried its jaws open and climbed back out. Sabin, it's time for me to teach you my ultimate technique. Use this to knock some sense into Kefka. Get ready. I call it the Phantom Rush. Now go! Hit Kefka with every blitz I taught you! Don't worry about me. Go! Defeat Kefka! So that's our first thing. We just got the Phantom Rush. Let's have a look here. Abilities. The Phantom Rush is a full circle, basically. Massive damage to a single enemy. The Phantom Rush and the Razor Gale are basically the most useful ones in the thing here. Rising Phoenix can be good for, you know, weakness to fire, or a cannon weakness to holy. Anyway, so that's that. now let's head back to that island where Sid was helping out keep Celis safe. Also, these are kind of the saddest things. They basically just literally die at you. The basic idea was, if you were playing as Celis and went out to explore the rest of the island, you'd basically just be running into a dying planet where everything was just... you know, everything was weak and on its last breath. Here we are. What is this? Quetzali Magicite. Let's have a look and see what Quetzali does here. Quetzali or Quetzalcoatl, depending on, depending on who you're, asking. But best part with him is he teaches Hastega and Sloga. Also, float. Hey, we can catch a fish. Yay! And the bird talks at us.
I'm all better now. Thank you, Celis.
Here's some more fish, Granddad.
Who the hell are you?
Oh yeah, so another interesting thing to check out here. Remember that guy way back when who was all like, I'm going to create a monument to war because war is the coolest thing ever and blah blah blah? Well, he actually went and did it. The Dragon's Neck Coliseum. The more valuable the item you wager, the better the prize will be if you win. This is the Dragon's Neck Coliseum. Champions from all over the world come here to fight for prizes and glory. I say the same thing, but slightly to the right.
Me, the great noble Ultros, reduced to working as a receptionist in this stinking Coliseum.
Oh yeah. You better not bet any cheap crap, or Mr. Typhon will have to come and teach you a lesson.
I'm an Imperial soldier. Probably the last one alive. I passed along a secret to that friend of yours with the bandana, though. Talk to the Emperor twice. It's a hint to finding the place where Emperor Gestal hid some legendary treasure. I've got no idea what it means. All battles in the Coliseum are one-on-one auto pets. Translation, it sucks. But hey, we can talk at people.
Toughest fighters from all over the world come here to compete. Finally, the whole world is at war. And I've fulfilled my lifelong ambition of building a Coliseum. I'm so happy, and I owe it all to Kafka.
Yeah, when we save the world, remind me to beat the shit out of that guy. Anyway.
I'm gonna make a killing here.
I'm also gonna make a killing here, but two squares to the right.
Okay, so we do have some suggestions for things to use. Let's make sure I'm not actually equipped with them at the moment.
Let's see here. Oh yeah, what's on this side?
It seems that an imposter has been masquerading as me recently. Don't be tricked.
Okay, so I think in this case what we're going to do is start by equipping splarps barps. Wow. Let's see, let's give Setzer a reflect ring. Just for funsies. Care to fight in the Coliseum? With pleasure. And we are going to bet... Actually, before we do that, we are going to step outside and save. We are going to save so hard. Because this is going to be... mild amounts of hell. Okay, so... we are going to try betting the regal gown. And laugh so hard because it actually worked! The death machine starts by casting death. So if we equip him, Setzer, with a reflect ring, it's basically hilarious. Anyway, so let's give him back the, heck with it, we'll give him the growth egg. But this means we have a much nicer piece of armor for Celis here. The Minerva Bustier, which just boosts kind of everything. It's like one of the ultimate pieces of equipment for female characters. Alright, so... let's find some friends, shall we? We're going to need to wait on some of the other Coliseum things, because we still need to find the Ichigeki sword. Anyway, let's see here. So let's head back to the Serpent's previously trench. And what used to be the city of Mobliz. Alright. Well, let's do this. Truly the best written lines in the game. Dog? I don't know what to do. Katarin's pregnant.
You're back! Katarin's going to be having a baby. I'm so happy that I'm going to have a child. But when I told that to Duane, he turned cold all of a sudden.
Katarin? I'm sorry. I just... didn't know how to handle all of this. Like an idiot, but everything's okay now. So please, come back home with me.
moment!
Please, protect the village! I don't have the strength to fight.
I'll keep Katarin safe.
I'll be fine with Duane by my side.
Woof.
So what we can learn from this is that number one, Humbaba hates poison, and number two, Humbaba skipped leg day.
I just wanted to say congratulations on the baby.
It's another monster! It's scary. I'm afraid. Mama? It's you, isn't it? I can tell. Terra? Mama!
Terra!
I'll fight. I think I finally understand the feeling that's been growing inside me. It must be love. I have to fight to protect the people I love and to make the world a safe place for new lives. Duane, keep Katarin and your baby safe. Children, Mama has to go away for a while to make the world a safer place for you to live. But I promise I'll be back as soon as I can.
Mama, I'm not gonna cry.
Me neither.
I'll be good, so come back soon.
Don't forget, you promised.
Thank you. You all helped me understand what it means to love. I'll fight. I'll make this world a place where life can flourish and children can grow up in peace.
What is love? Baby, don't hurt Humbaba. Or actually hurt the crap out of Humbaba. Oh yeah, we should probably check on... Oh, let's equip Terra. Actually, the man-eater knife might be her best thing. She's actually done up pretty well, isn't she? Well, let's give her some relics at least. The sprint shoes, and... I don't know. It's peace, right? Yeah, we'll give her the hero's ring. That works. And Terra, let's have you equip Katsali. Alright. See how the kids are doing?
I hope Katarin has her baby soon. I want to see it.
We'll be alright.
Duane and Katarin will take good care of us.
I'm not gonna cry. I don't want to make Mama sad.
Mama, we'll be okay. We're tough.
Baby in Katarin's belly is kicking. Katarin, what are you gonna name the baby? There, it just kicked again.
A new life. I've got to do my best to help make the world a safer place for it.
We'll be okay. So please, go make sure these kids have a future to look forward to.
Can't save the world because there's a kid stuck in the doorway. There we go. Okay. I hope one of these kids is a trained midwife. You know, the Cub Scout patches stop just short. Alright, so now we have Terra, and due to having three members in the party, this would be a great time to pick up our good buddy Gao. This is about the spot? Yes, the music says that yes, this is the spot. Back attacked!
Your friend, I join you again.
And there he is again. That was relatively simple. So, let's decide who's going to be where. Nice chair.
All right, let's do this.
So, who shall our party members be? Definitely keeping Setzer in there. And Celis, because I just like Celis. Yeah, Edgar and Sabin. They're our kind of our central party, so. Well, the central party for this half of the game, anyway. Pretty well? I think so. Alright. Let's save just in case. This appears like a Crescent Mountain. Oh, here's Crescent Mountain. Or what used to be Crescent Mountain, I guess. Interceptor! Are you trying to tell me to follow you? Bah! Celis learned Fyra, and that master is Medun. Let's give her, like, 10 seconds of catchy, I guess. Bah! Let's try this. Okay, so Sabin might not be leaving our party ever. There we go. Now she's Master Kashi. We've got Unicorn, Katoba Pass, Phantom. Let's work on the rest of Phantom, I guess. She's got some more of that to do. Let's see. Interceptor was going this way, so... Meh.
Of us go hunting on the Veldt, we always run across the fully dressed in hides.
Yeah, we met him.
For some reason, that boy never shows up when all four of us are out there together.
They're huge dinosaurs in the forest north of the Veldt. They're incredibly strong. There's no way a human could defeat one, but it sure would be something to brag about if you did.
They always leave me here so they can try to befriend that kid. I don't want to go hunting with them anyway.
Nah. 3 feet away from the campfire.
Berserker ring.
That is the downside of the chainsaw. The instant death attack isn't the most accurate. Well, at least that got Celis to Master Phantom. So, what else are we going to teach her? Actually, let's borrow Quetzali from Terra. That should do a trick. Hidden thing here. Ah.
Oh, hey, the Ichigeki. Really useful, actually. Ichigeki is Japanese for one strike. Although that wasn't actually what I was meaning to do. Sabin has just mastered Ramu, so it's actually really close to mastering Siren, so let's give him that one. See if I can find what I'm looking for, the other thing I'm looking for in the process. So there are reasons for why Kefka's doing what he's doing. And maybe I'll even explain them at some point, who knows. Sabin learned silence. Not like he'll ever... Here we go.
Monster in a box!
Oh, you little fucker. Run back up this way. No, too far. Phoenix down. Too many people made fun of the fact his laugh sounds like a stalling car engine mixed with a record scratch. Jeez. So let's see who can equip the tiger fang. Apparently not you. Presumably not you. Ah, it's for Sabin. And everything is made better by it. Sounds good to me. Ah. Setzer. Picking things up pretty nicely here. Let's give him Carbuncle. And Edgar. Shiva, sure. There we go. Now we can head where we were going.
Oh hey, there's a new path to go. Freaking praying mantises. Okay, let's try the... Here we are. Okay. There's a safe point up there. I'll bet. Ah, here we go. Also, let's sort the items. We haven't done that in a while. Okay. Also, save. Okay, so up through here. These ones are awful.
Oh, fur!
Ah! Sensor, stop being dead. Something's coming from behind!
Another monster appears.
Oh. Well, that's what happens when you, decide to go be undead, and you just kind of like, well... Five magic AP, and save and learn Confuse. Also, two behemoth suits, which will come in way handy when we get Realm and Strago back.
We can't do anything for wounds like these here.
Let's fly back to Thamasa on the double. Thank you.
Oh, he must be having a nightmare. You came to try and stop me. I'm sorry, but I can't turn back, boy. Stay here with my daughter. You both deserve to live in peace. All we can do now is wait. The rest will help. Hey, how you feeling? It's only a scratch. I've had worse. I've got this guy watching over me. He prepared you soup. Wow. I'm impressed. You have a terrifyingly smart dog.
There aren't any good places left to play.
I saw a huge monster fly across the sky. I saw a huge monster fly across the sky. It looked like a giant bat. Oh, hey.
Abbott's Rock is above water for the first time in 50 years. Head north of town and you should be able to see it.
It's hard to believe it's only been a year since the cataclysm. It feels like it's been ages.
After the cataclysm, I awoke to find myself all alone in Dover Castle. When I tried to sleep there, monsters came for me in my dreams. Still frightens me just to think of it. Well, hey. At least the inn visits are still only, like, a gil per night. I wonder what their, inventory is like. Maybe it's the same as before, but... an extra mystery veil for, well, my mommy might not go amiss. Let's see, circlet... no one in the party really needs one. Luminous robe. Cowl, diamond. Yeah, we'll get to that when we have those characters back. Da Vinci brush. Or is that what? Pick one up. Holy rod. Gravity rod. Fuma shuriken. So Fuma is Japanese for wind demon. It was also the, it was also the name for a clan of ninja, the most notorious of whom being Fuma Kotaro. Thank you.
There we go. And what kind of relics are we looking at? The same as ever. Okay. Princess Ring is only equipable by... Well, actually, that kind of makes sense. Okay. Now for something fun to do. Let's head back to the Coliseum. And remember to save outside first. Hey, you care to fight in the Coliseum? With pleasure. We are going to wager the Ichigeki. And look who's back to join us. Let's try Sabin. Sabin. Really? Libra? There we go. What are you doing here? The only thing I know how to do. I'm fighting. And why don't you come with us? Perhaps I should. Alright. Time to put my skills to the ultimate test. And that's how we gained... And that's how we gained Shadow. Let's save again. Let's see. Time to move on to another... to the next thing. Okay, so... Let's see, for this next part...
General Leo, I think I've begun to understand the things you told me.
This part we are going to send Terra and Shadow as ambassadors. Oh, wait. Grab a third. If something were to happen to me, all the world's ladies would grieve. So, Terra, Shadow, and Sabin. Make sure they're actually equipped with things. Actually, I should probably unequip everyone else so we have the best stuff for the party. Keep having to remember these things. Okay, so. Oh, you've already got sprint shoes on. Okay. Well, in that case, we'll remove your sprint shoes and replace them with the growth egg. I think having a Shadow with Fenrir, you know, teleport and vanish, sounds pretty thematically appropriate for Shadow. Alright, let's do this. Wow, I'm completely... We're just kind of sailing wherever right now. I don't even know. Lower, higher, whee! Okay. Okay, now that I've done all that nonsense, let's land and we're going to visit Narshe. That's creepy. Magicide. Okay, so that's the same as... Okay. Well, these guys aren't letting a little thing like the end of the world do anything. Hey? Haven't we met someplace before? Eh, whatever. Nothing left in this town anyway, except for that one lousy moogle. Doors are all locked, and you'd have to be some kind of treasure hunter to get them open. And might I say again... Sabin learned Imp. Will probably never come in handy, but you never know. That's awkward. Oh yeah, back in Arvis's house. So we have some chests to check out, apparently. Well, that sounds naughty. But we have some items to check here. Presuming I remembered to actually leave them alone last time. He's not silenced anymore. Yeah. Well, whatever that would have been, oh well. So the arrows around Sabin, my guess is that's their way of dealing with the fact that the IOS release and, also hi bug. Yeah, the IOS and Android releases, you wouldn't have had shoulder buttons to deal with. And so they figured that was the next best thing. Which is actually kind of good because the inputs from my controller are kind of sloppy. Ooh, Shadow learned how to teleport. No one is safe. Is it down this way, I think? Ah! There was at least one chest thing that I forgot to grab or something like that. I don't know. I have like a 50% chance of the controller just absolutely biffing my attack inputs, which is annoying because Sabin here has at the moment one of the best attack abilities in the game. He just can't use it with any measure of predictability.
Wow, I'm like so badly lost right now. Okay, so let's try that again, only less wandering back out of town. As you can see, Interceptor has not lost his taste for you. Okay, so let's try this again. Inside, let's head north. Right, we need to go to Moogle Land, don't we?
You don't die, Koopa. Oh, I'm so glad you're alive, Koopa. I'll help you fight, Koopa. Oh, I'll bet the Yeti will come along too. He'll be a big help, Koopa. He can be a little wild, though, Koopa. He should be here in the mine somewhere. He'll help us if I order him to. Let's look for him, Koopa.
Granted, considering that Terra's favorite hobby is fluffing Moogles, Mog is going to be really, really tired of his position in the party pretty darn soon. Wow. Mog can equip some pretty darn heavy armor, actually. Okay, so. Obtained Malulu's Charm. This is an item that can only be equipped by Mog. Wherever it went. Here we are, Malulu's Charm. Prevents all random enemy encounters. But since leveling up is kind of a nice thing to do, we're not going to do that quite yet. But anyway. Oh, here's that chest. It gets us another ribbon, so. See, she's got one. Let's give one to Sabin. Oh, right, that, instead of the Gygas glove, let's give him the Memento Ring, because he's one of the few who can actually equip it. So, back to town. Video description thought she that Terra was from DuckTales? What? I have some unfortunate news for that person. So now we're going to go in the front side of the mines. Although actually, perhaps first we should pay a visit to the back. I should really work on not being so
easily surprised by predictable events, and yet here I am. That was odd. So Mog can summon a tapir. That's a thing. Well, continuing with Shadow doing all the sneaky ninja stuff, let's start teaching Grass, Osmos, and Shell. Yeah. Much better. Okay, so we're gonna step outside and save for a moment. You know, to celebrate finding Mog. And back in we go. Ah! Starting to understand why they give you Malulu's charm right about there. That was creepy. So this time we're going up the mines the regular way. Okay, that's not it. As you can probably hear, we're
we're definitely having a lot of fun with Puppy around. Okay, that's... Seriously, no wonder they give you Malulu's charm right about here. And Shadow has mastered the Zona Seeker. So let's see what else we can do for disruption. Berserk Vanish Gravity sounds good for Disruptive Ninja. Okay, so... Oh, fucking really? See, this is why I am so annoyed at some of these things, like... You know, it'll just randomly ignore one of my inputs when I'm doing the... when I'm performing the inputs for the blitzes. And it's like, haha, never mind, you just wasted a turn. I'm like, screw you. Anyway. 3 steps I took.
Okay, so we're back to that snowfield that we confronted Kefka in. Also, there is a dragon here that we don't really feel like dealing with, so let's just run and go. Oh hey, at least it taught us a new dance, so... The Snowman Rondo calls upon the power of winter to attack enemies and heal allies. Yeah, not bad, I guess. Ah! Oh my gosh, Terra's tent is freaking adorable. Okay, anyway, Okay, so, looks like... to deal with, okay, so we've got something that is going to be weak to fire, and okay, let's see here. Oh, now that... really? Got another person with fire up. Also, Terra mastered unicorn. Hurrah! Terra has mastered a lot of things. Okay. We're probably going to want Zona Seeker for this battle. throat. Okay. So. Quickly. So, humans broke my seal of ice. Humans who possess magicide.
Just who are you? I suppose that's of little consequence. But what of this devastation that fills the air? Could the War of the Magi have lasted 1,000 years? That foolish, unending war. You would seek to put an end to it? Then I shall put my trust in you.
Obtained Valigarmanda, Magicite. Let's take a moment. Terra is going to be the first one to start learning from Valigarmanda because Fyriga Blizziga Thundaga. Let's step back for a moment, save again. Real anticlimax there, guys. Frickin' heck! Okay, so let's see what. Actually, let's see what Mog looks like when he goes camping. Aww. Okay, that's kind of cute. Also, freaking dragon, right there. Let's not be in that area soon. Okay, so. So an opening of a cliff. Let's check it out. Well, this music is different. So, for one thing, apparently we're going to have to deal with a lot of imp status. Also, the thing on the left is going to kill us very quickly, so. I really like this music. Anyway, so. Take the right door.
Okay, so water is not the way to go here. Ether. Let's see. So, it's up this way. Ah! So, let's see here. Ignore the first switch. Hold second.
Ah!
That was useful. That's a skull on stick. Okay. What's with this carving? It looks like bone. Hey, is that thing stuck in the eye socket? Magicite? Let's pop that out. Midgard's armor! You know, the Midgar Zolom. Thank you. energized with a green cherry instead of, usually the cherry turns people into imps.
I'm your boss, Koopo! You're gonna join us, Koopo!
A yeti with a love of bone carvings. Stronger than a gygus, but a bit unruly. Let's see, according to the guide here, he is age 4, height 6'10", class Berserker. His weapon is other party members. His skill is going berserk. He likes imps, dislikes caterpillars, and has a hobby of carving bones. And his name is Umaro. So yeah, Umaro has a habit of throwing party members at enemies. Being thrown removes confusion and sleep, which is kinda nice. He is incredibly powerful, but the only thing he can equip is relics. He has, let's see, Berserker Ring, which lets him throw party members around, and the Blizzard Orb, which gives him Snowstorm. So let's head back to... Seriously. Let's see. We can try fighting the, Oh, wait, other way. We can try to fight that ice dragon in the snowfield, but honestly, I don't feel like it. Which way do I go? Friggin'. Gah. Creepy ghostly Moogle. Shadow. That's how we do it. Okay. Also, take a moment to heal ourselves back up. Okay. And save. Okay, so. Ah.
Okay, so there are legendary dragons wandering the world of ruin. If we defeat all of them, we unlock the Crusader Esper. In original Japanese, it was known as Jihad. You might imagine why that was changed in translation. Anyway, let's take a quick moment to have a look through our bestiary. Oh, we're actually missing some, I guess. So, oh well. I guess we can at least have a look around and see what... Ugh. Well, that thing's creepy. And that's why it's called the Ichigeki. One strike, death. Well, yes, the direct translation of Jihad is a struggle, translated from Arabic. However, considering the connotations that Jihad tends to have these days, Shadowmaster Phantom. Sleep, silence, and slow? We'll start with Confuse, Imp, and Float. Looks like all we're finding is crawlers here, so... But hey, Mogler and Sloga and Hastiga. Let's see, Quake, Graviga, and Tornado. Yeah, I think we're gonna give you, actually, why not have you talk to Roma for a while? He's your old pal. Okay, so back to the airship. Also, save. Okay, so our next place to visit, Southwestern Island. I think that's so small. Shadur. Okay. Flying to this little weird bit off to the side. And back to that town we were supposed to be visiting earlier. Hey, do you know what a cactuar is? I bent hunting the little varmints last time I was out in the desert, and all of a sudden a huge one attacked me.
Monster of that size has to have some good treasure. I'd bet my right eye on it. How about you, Mr.,
I was a thief once, but then I uncovered a secret so terrible that I had to go into hiding. Also, I took up meth.
A swordsman came through here recently. His skills were impressive enough, but I could tell his heart was full of turmoil. If he could rid himself of that confusion and doubt, his technique would surely reach a whole new level.
A man with a strange manner of speech came through town long ago. Kept calling people something funny. Vu? Tao? Yao? Meow? Something like that. Ooh. Better equipment. So let's take two crystal hounds. And an oath veil. In fact, two oath veils. Black garbs. And there goes my budget for the month. Okay. White bridle. Oh, that's awkward. Bridal veil. Okay.
How to find?
Ah, nice thing to do, just tell people how to find things.
The sources of people's misery always lie in their pasts. Lost friends, families, and homelands, these are the things that torment people the most.
I suppose that's better than, like, the big source of their grief being the future. Hey, you know the guy in Zozo who says this place is dangerous? He's the only honest guy in that town. If you need something there, he's the one to ask. Gravity Rod, Sword Breaker. Shadow Scroll. Invisibility, Water, Lightning, Flame, useful things. Falchion. Okay, I'll have to come back when I grab more money. Okay, the woman who was being chased by the Imperial soldier is now just running around by herself.
Thal has been receiving a lot of letters lately. I wonder if they're from her boyfriend in Mobliz. Well, this is going to be awkward.
Out of desperation, I tried to climb the cult of Kefka's tower to steal the treasure. I barely made it out of the first treasure room alive, and had to turn back. These flowers are made of silk. Quite beautifully, too.
Look at all these flowers! My boyfriend in Mobli sent them to me. Look closely, they're all handmade. Real flowers won't bloom anymore, so he made me these from silk. And he just sent me this letter. But wasn't Mobli destroyed by Kefka? Someone else must have written that letter.
My beloved Lola, art thou well? We have rebuilt as much of the village as we could hope to. I believe I should be able to return to thy side before too long.
This handwriting looks a lot like Cayenne's. But where is he mailing them from? Oh, could you please attach this reply to the carrier pigeon outside?
Sure.
Thank you.
Follow that bird!
Well, we've got some things to think about, don't we? What the? Oh, heck. Oh, fucking hell. Well, that's annoying. And you kind of have to defeat him in order to, Oh boy. There's a magicite you can only get by defeating him, and it falls out of his mouth. Okay. Better save before that thing attacks again, and back to Zozo. Zozo? Never heard of it. Ah. At least things are easier to kill now. Well, I'm not sure if that guy's dead or merely passed out drunk, but either way, I don't think we want to bother him much. Hey, climb to the top of the building with the pub sign? You'll find a path leading to Mount Zozo. Monsters up there are quick. If you go, you better have a way of making sure you'll be able to hit them. Like one of those, you know, sniper whatchamacallits.
Oh yeah, this rust rib will help you open that door up there. Yours for 1,000 gil, how about?
Sure.
There. Well, that's not nearly as annoying now, at least. The rust dissolves. Oh, for heck's sake! If his blitz is actually... Anyway. Let's see. So, here we have... Ice Shield! And yet another... Oh my gosh. Down this way, we'll get attacked again. Ah! Okay, at least he learned Rama from it. Or mastered Rama from it. Let's give him a unicorn. Thunder shield. Oh, okay. That actually worked pretty well. Okay. Give our elemental shields to the characters who can't equip the heavier ones. Aegis Shield. It needs your help. Oh, also sometimes repels magic attacks. Nice. Ooh. Also a gold hairpin, which is going straight on Terra. Half MP cost. Else is gonna have to get that one. So you get the sprint shoes now. There's the sunbeam. The Glacia Lobolus. Glacia Lobolus apparently is one of the demons mentioned in the Key of Solomon. Ah. Save point. Alright, Shadow, let's see what your tent looks like.
Oh, it has a shuriken on the top of it.
Aww.
Okay, we are not stepping on the switch in the northeast because that will get us attacked by a dragon. Okay, so... okay, so, let's see here. Yes, in case we need to throw the tent. That's why it has the shirt on it.
Writing to beg for your forgiveness. I am guilty of perpetuating a terrible lie. I have only now realized the error of my ways and taken up this quill in hopes of correcting a great wrong. Your boyfriend, who you believed to be in Mobliz, passed away some time ago. I have been writing to you in his stead. We humans have a tendency to become trapped in the past and refuse to move on. I implore you not to let this happen. Now is a time for you to look forward, rediscover love and all the other joys of life. Kayen. Locked. Memories of the world before the fall remain, but the light of dawn doth never change, nor ere the hearts of men.
Kayan!
Thou art alive!
Kayan!
I shall go with thee. We must not abandon the world to Kefka. But... however did thou find me? Wait, tell me thou did not read my letters! These are a minor diversion of mine.
Kayan, these flowers are gorgeous.
Oh. Must thou embarrass me so?
Dost thou truly think so?
I wondered what had happened, or what had become of that poor girl, always waiting for word of your beloved. I decided to pay a visit to Maran. I learned that she had long since stopped receiving replies, but still sent a letter each day. I could not bear to stand by and do nothing. As I wrote to that girl, I began to realize that I was no different. I was refusing to move on. I could not let go. I will no longer live in the past. We must all look forward, or we must all look to the future now. It's locked.
Oh hey, a shiny thing.
The key to Cayenne's treasure chest.
Well, what are these?
Machinery for dunces? A pictorial guide to machines? Everything about machines?
Machines for the mechanically disinclined? And...
Bushido in the bedroom?
Several simple books on machinery, and a book of special samurai techniques. Oh my. Well, there we have it.
So, back we go to Zozo. Let's definitely save again. Oh, well, there we go. Shadow learn flow, which means he's good with catchy. So who's next in the bio break and death? Sounds like Katobloppas will be a good match for Shadow at least. And back out into Zozo. And I think that's... yep. Sabin has mastered Ifrit. Give him Carbuncle next. Rather befitting of his status as the tank. Okay, so now we have Cyan. Or Cyan. Okay, so now it's time to go back to the Coliseum. See, we want Mog, Shadow, and a Urasaven. Also, the annoying randomness of the Coliseum. So, we are going to equip Shadow with got the Ichigeki, optimized armor, and his relics, Memento Ring, and the Hermes Sandals. Save again. First step. We're going to bet one of those behemoth suits. Shadow will be the one taking on the outsider. Hot damn!
Okay, that went really fast. Oh my gosh.
Okay, So, we just won a Snow Scarf, which is basically the best possible armor for Mog. Look what it does to his everything. seriously, oh my gosh. Also, it absorbs ice damage. So, you know. Okay, so Mog is now going to just be, like, way out doing, like, everything. Let's take a moment and save, because holy crap.
What the f-
Okay, seriously, game, attacking me right as I step out of the freaking plate. That's just not nice. Let's stay at the inn for a moment just to make up. Seriously! Who even does that? Now let's save. Let's see, do we have... Need to see if we have a falchion. And no, it does not look like we do. So, we're going to have to make a quick stop back by, Thamasa again. For heaven's sake! Okay, so, I think this was where we could pick up the falchion. If not, I'll have to try to remember. How am I so bad at this? Let's pick up a black cowl for Shadow as long as we're here. Oh, maybe it was in Miranda. Really starting to miss those sprint shoes, aren't we? Here we are, falchion. will get 3. Let's see. Scrolls. Gravity rod. Sword breaker. Let's grab one of those, I guess. So, Terra, you now get the falchion. Just trying to walk down the stairs, old man. You're off on your evening constitutional. It's like, So we're going to save again. So now, we shall fight again in the Coliseum, and we shall bet one of these falchions. Shadow, you're up. Extremely fuck. Okay, so speaking of dickish. That's why we are saving the game outside the Coliseum every time, because stuff like that happens, and it's just not right. Oh yeah, Mog, you're going to swap your Aegis Shield for the Golden Shield just for a little bit, so that we can put the, put it on Shadow. You can have the Ice Shield instead. So let's try betting the falchion again, and see what Shadow can do this time. Shadow. Oh, fucking! Make sure that Shadow is equipped with the rest of the good stuff in place. Okay. There we go. So now we have a flame shield. Let's see, so this says, time to start winning a playset of one of the best relics of the game. So. Saving again because, ugh. Okay, so this time our challenger will be Edgar. Sabin. He's gonna, here. So they recommend Hermes sandals and a Gale hairpin. Let's see how this goes. So this time we have to risk an elixir and hope that Sabin can use his. Okay, maybe not Bat Blitz, but. Okay. Well, never mind. Let's try that again. Fuck's sake, Sabin. It's still not working. Sabin? Sabin? Mama didn't raise no stupids. What are you doing? Sabin, what the fucking fuck are you doing, you fuckhead? You utter waste of oxygen. Okay, there we go. This gets us a rename card. The walkthrough recommends that I get 4 of these. This is going to hurt. Sorry, something's being stupid here. And I think it's my mouse. let's go out. Save. He's right back to being an idiot. We're not going to even give that the dignity of finishing. Well, that was vaguely intelligent-ish, I guess. Sabin, what the fuck are you doing? Okay, we're only getting one, I think at this point we are just only going to get one of these, items, because what even the hell? So, what we are going to do instead. So we equip Mog with the Snow Scarf and the Flame Shield. And we give him the Hermes Sandals and an Angel Ring. Sure to save a lot there. Okay, so that's what we're going to do. Is we're going to bet that rename card that we bought, that we won in the last one. Wherever it went. Where'd it go? this fucking game, I swear. Okay, let's take a moment. Sort. There it is, rename card. So what the rename card usually does is allow you to rename a character to use. But if we bet it in the Coliseum, and send a... Oh wait, Mog. Well, let's see what happens. Well, on the bright side, Mog is basically a physical wall. And Southern Cross heals him, so... Raccoon! Well, okay then. I guess raccoons are like mega healers or something. Oh my gosh, how many times is it going to use that fucking Heartless Angel attack? Meanwhile, Mog is fucking. Well, at least Southern Cross will, Oh, Foss Mount heals him. Good. Okay. This is going to take a while, isn't it? Oh my gosh, give your angel a heart already. Miracle Shoes! Okay, so... as long as we're here, we are abusing the heck out of the inn as well, but...
could you? I was your partner. You should be here with me.
So yeah, when you stay at an inn with Shadow in your party, you have a chance of Shadow having a nightmare about his past, which you just witnessed there. So let's see. Here's the... So, we are now going to give Mog the Miracle Shoes, because... Haste, Protect, Shell, and Regenerate. And now, if we give him a ribbon, he's basically unstoppable. So yeah, let's see if we can get Sabin to be less awful. Scale hairpin, frequency of camera strikes. Okay, so Sabin, try not sucking this time. See what you can do with that. No. You know what? I am going to swap out that Gale hairpin for... a peace ring, because I am so fucking sick of getting preserved. So he casts Cure on himself. Sabin. Who wrote the battle AI for this fucking section of the game? Like, characters are just compelled to do the dumbest possible things over and over again. Know what? It's 10 o'clock. I'm done with the stream. I'm going to just bash my head against the things for a while, maybe off stream or something, but oh my. Like, what the fuck? Oh. This is such a good game, and then this section happens. So, anyway, I hope you all had fun tonight watching me suffer. I'll try and be back in again on Wednesday evening. Same time, same place. Hopefully not the same outcome, because what even the hell? All right, I will catch you all next time. Have a good evening. I'm Simon the Shepherd, and this has been Gaming with Dog.